music, but we still have fun.
I'm your biggest fan, I'll follow you until you love me. Papa, paparazzi, baby, there's no other superstar, you know that I'll be your papa.
With WOAMTEC from Studio K in Orlando, Florida. And now, here's Kathleen Hawkins.
I'm Kathleen Hawkins, your proud president and founder of WOAMTEC, and we have got some spectacular guests that will be sharing with us today. I can't wait for you to meet these women. These women are just amazing, and they've not only touched my lives, but I know that they can touch yours. First, I'd like to start with a stellar individual of the Dr. Phillips Divas, the DP Divas. Lorraine and I were talking, and she shared with me just some very insightful tips, and she's working with us to help you and all of your members benefit even more from their WOAMTEC experience. And basically, when I was talking to her about our situation, Lorraine kind of filled me in on how I could have taken a very stressful, difficult time in my life and added a little sunshine, made it a little bit brighter. And I asked her to be here today because I know that most of our women, most of our business members are self-employed entrepreneurs. And because of that, we have more risk at stake, don't we, Lorraine? It's like crazy.
Absolutely, because we're by ourselves sometimes, doing it on our own.
So why don't you start by telling everybody who you are and what you do.
Sure. I'm Lorraine Trulock. I'm an agent with Aflac. I'm sure most of you have seen the duck on TV, the crazy duck commercials, and I think 96% of Americans have heard of the duck, but most people don't know really what Aflac does.
You know, and I think that's why it was important, and that's why I thought that it was crucial to bring WOAMTEC to WOAMTEC and kind of share it. Do we have a duck noise actually happening right now? That is crazy. How is that possible? Jeff, can you put me on too instead of just having it be Lorraine real quick? I think that it's really important because when we're talking and when I talk to you, WOAMTEC, you shared with me something that could help so many of our WOAMTEC members. And as you know, about a year and a half ago, my stepfather passed away. And it was a very traumatic point in my life because we supported my mom and my dad. And we counted on them greatly to help with our kids after we adopted. And my dad got sick. And he spent weeks after weeks after weeks being in the hospital. And it was just such a stressful time in our lives. And I remember thinking every time he went, it was like, oh, no, we've got to go through this again. And it wasn't that I didn't want to be superficial or uncaring or unloving, but it was such a financial burden, such an emotional burden, such a stressful position for my mother to go through and for him to go through. Like, he didn't want to go to the hospital when he knew he needed to because he felt like he was inconveniencing all of us. So let's talk about that. You did say that most entrepreneurs, what do they experience?
Well, you know, most entrepreneurs are out there sometimes, like I said, on their own, and if they're not bringing in income, you know, what happens to their family? What happens to their kids? What happens to their lifestyle? When you mentioned cancer, for example, Aflac is such a company that cares. It's one of the reasons I really went to work for Aflac. They really care about us as people, and when it comes to illnesses or accidents or injuries, at that point, you know, there's doctors and there's hospitals that have to be paid, but what about us? What about our bills? What about our mortgages and our car payments and our daycare and taking care of our families? And if it's just us doing it, you know, that's a question that you ask when something happens catastrophically.
So it's not just a duck and it's not just health insurance.
No.
It's more than that. It's what is supplemental insurance mean for an entrepreneur?
Great. That's a great question. I think one thing that I tell people when they think of insurance, most people think of major medical insurance because they think of paying the doctors and paying the hospitals. But who pays us? Who pays me? Who pays my bills? So that's what Aflac does. What Aflac does is we've got over 50 million clients, policyholders worldwide. We've got 11 different programs. But the idea behind Aflac is that when you're sick, when you're injured, in the event there's, heaven forbid, a cancer diagnosis, the last thing that you want to worry about is, where do I get the money to go to the cancer center and get a second opinion? How do I fly my mother down here to be with me while I am sick and take care of me? So that's what the Aflac does. The money goes directly to us, to the policyholders, so that not to pay the doctor, not to pay the hospital, but to take care of the things that we have to every day.
I think that's so important because, you know, they say that when God will always provide, and they say that when you're hit with something that's tough, like you mentioned earlier, that also often we say, I've just got to focus on this, I'm not going to worry about this,
right?
And whenever the bill comes, I'll figure it out then. And
yes,
then you end up with bad credit or major financial obligations, or you leave the burden to somebody else.
Right.
Or like my father, you may make decisions that could be hurting your health because you're afraid of inconveniencing other people.
Right.
And that's why I wanted to talk about this, because it's not about selling Aflac. It's about really protecting our entrepreneurs that are members,
correct,
that are out there, that are maybe a single mom, or, you know, maybe married, but if something happens to your child, like you said, I wouldn't want to have to go to the Mayo Clinic somewhere without my husband.
Absolutely.
I would want him there to help me, because it would be such, you have to be strong, and
right,
we can be strong, but it still is helpful when you have someone to lean on.
To lean on, sure.
And someone to help you out.
Well, that's a good point, you know, when you bring up about being an entrepreneur. Sure, you can have a husband, or you can have a spouse that helps, but obviously we're all working because we need that second income. So when you're working and you need the second income and someone can't work because of their own illness or a child's illness, that's when Aflac really comes in. You know, I have my own story, actually. When I first started with Aflac, I took a couple of the plans to help me, and I am a single mom, and I'm an independent agent that works for Aflac, and so one of the plans I took out was our accident policy, and I took it out mainly because I have a son who's always getting hurt. So I thought, this will be the way that at least in those times when he's hurt and he has to go see a doctor, go to the emergency room and get an x-ray, you know, Aflac will give me the money to cover some expense. And about 6 months into having the program, I ruptured a disc in my back by lifting a water box from Publix, and ended up in the hospital for the first time ever, besides having children. I had surgery for the first time ever. I was in the hospital for about 5 or 6 days, went through physical therapy, went through doctor visits. I then had to have a second surgery 2 months later. It had re-ruptured, and Aflac said no problem. Aflac is, the image I give people is, think of a bank teller. And so you go to your bank specifically to get money, and you walk up to the window, and you fill out your deposit slip, and you say, you know, here's how much money I need. And the teller goes back and processes it and gives you the money. That's exactly what Aflac did. I took my bills, my hospital bill, my doctor bill, the surgeon bill. I filled out the claim form. I faxed it on a Saturday. And by the following Friday, I had over $5,000 for my first one. And I ended up getting more for even the second one as well. So what would I do without that money? I'm self-employed. I'm a single mom. Don't have any short-term disability insurance. And an accident is something that we never see coming. I never saw it coming for me. So that when I talk about caring, that's why I set up the association for the WOAMTEC members, knowing that we all have families, we all have things to take care of, we all have places to live and things to take care of, and we may have health insurance, you may have major medical, you may not have major medical, but in the event that you're hurt or that you're injured, who will pay your bills? Who will help you? That's what Aflac does.
And who will help your kids? I think that's so important.
Yeah.
I think that it's interesting that all too often as moms, we say, oh, well, I'll do that because my son is
right,
a boy.
Right.
And boys have a tendency of being evil Knievels and causing problems or getting in trouble more often or hurting themselves more
right,
often. But all too often, we don't say, well, I may get cancer, or
right,
I may get hurt,
right,
or I may end up in the hospital. And if you're a member that is self-employed, that is a mom, you know, who's going to help? What's going to happen with all the other burdens, all the other things that you do, all the other income things that you do?
Absolutely. And at the time that you're sick or an illness were to take place, or, like I said, heaven forbid, a child, to be diagnosed with some form of cancer, the financial part of that can create so much more stress.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it alleviates that. Aflac wants to really be that company that's there for us, that in those times when we need it most, during an emotional time, during an illness, that you don't have to worry about, where do I get the money to take care of what I need to take care of.
That's awesome.
It's
and I
great.
Know personally, just in thinking about my father, you know, it was 18 months worth of doctor's appointments, hospital visits, stress, agony. It was a very difficult time for
sure.
Our family. And I think his treatment would have probably been better. I think the household probably would have been better. I know just in talking to you with the policies, if we would have had some of those policies in place, it would have relieved a huge financial burden, not only on my mother, but on all of us.
Right.
And that's why it was important for me to have you share this. Now,
right.
We're working on setting up an association to where, tell me about that, what
Correct.
We're working on doing.
Correct. What's kind of neat is we, Aflac, anyone can get Aflac. You can call Aflac and sign up for any of the plans right now. But by being a member of an association, we are then eligible for some discounted premiums and discounted programs. So the process is in the works right now. I'm not quite sure of the logistics of exactly how it's going to work, but I've got the association set up. Somehow it will then be on our member website, and you'll be able to get in communication. I want everyone to know, though, that if you have an Aflac member in your chapter or you know an Aflac associate or Aflac agent, they will absolutely be able to work with the association and use the association rate once it's set up. So this is, you know, good for anybody around the country. Anyone can take advantage of the association. So we're in the works. It should be finalized fairly quickly, but I'm really excited to be able to offer this at some discounts, which I think will help people.
That's awesome. So we can not only save a little bit of money, but
yes.
Because you're a WOAMTEC member,
correct.
Benefit a little bit more. We can protect our family. We can protect our parents. If you have parents that may be a little bit older in age, that may become somebody that you will have to monitor and mentor and love, like my mom,
right.
Which is very important. But also, you can, if you have an Aflac member in your chapter, you can have them call the corporate office or call Lorraine, and we'll put you in touch with how to make this happen.
Absolutely.
And if you don't have an Aflac member in your chapter, I strongly suggest you find one and recruit them. So have them come to the luncheon, because I think it's really important. We need protection. So many people today are without health care that is ridiculous. The growing
yeah.
number of Americans without health care is just sad. And we need to protect you, but we also need to protect our assets. And we're going to hear a little bit more about that from Attorney Barbara Cohenson in just a second. But I am so glad we heard a little bit from you today.
Thank you,
and,
Kathleen.
You're very, very welcome. Now, I know we're going to give away a prize. Every show we give away a few special prizes. And one of the show's prizes today, we're going to give you a fabulous t-shirt, so you can wear it as the summer approaches on your morning walks or your visits to the beach or whatever it is that you do. But we're also going to give you an Aflac koozie
yes.
To cool down and refresh yourself with it. So the first winner is going to be the first person that logged into WOAMTEC's live broadcast today. And CMR Arivas, our National Events Coordinator, is our webmaster today. Everybody give C a shout out if you are online. Make sure you let C know. And the first person who logged in is going to win the first prize, and I was just informed by the C. Revis that it's Lisa, our Buckhead Chapter Director, who had an incredibly stellar meeting this week. I believe she had 8 guests at the meeting. She had an amazing group of women. She is a growing Buckhead, and I am so blessed to have you as a leader on one of our leadership teams. So thank you, Lisa. You are the winner of the first prize, and
Yay.
I know you will look like a diva with the t-shirt carrying your koozie for us. So thank you so much for being here today. And Lauren, thank you so much for being here today. You're a blessing to us.
Oh, thank you,
and
Kathleen.
You look fabulous.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And thanks for having me.
My pleasure. Thank you. Take care.
You're welcome.
I also want to mention a couple of updates and a couple of announcements. We have the Orlando Confident Woman Conference coming up soon. Woohoo! And I know Lisa, and we have Jenny Bishop, and we have a bunch of directors, Paula Sheffield from Valdosta, that are coming down from Georgia. Trixie Walker from West Palm Beach is coming over. Marilyn from Tallahassee, I heard, was coming down. So we've got, Jacksonville. We can't forget Jacksonville is coming down to visit us. It is going to rock, but this is an important update. A lot of you guys, for some reason, aren't yet getting all of our correspondence for the conference, and you need to know we are already 75% sold out, and we sold our last conference booth today, so C's doing a wonderful, wonderful job. This is going to be the best conference ever. I, of course, am going to be speaking a little bit. Roy Biancalanca is going to talk to us about laws of feminine attraction, but also how to make that connection and use your femininity to make a difference in your business, which I think is going to be really stellar to hear a man's perspective to what a woman can use. And then we're also going to hear from the wonderful Wendy Lynn Phillips. She's doing an entirely new program on image and your look and being the best you. But I will be sharing a lot of great new secrets. So if you don't know what a tiny brochure card is, is, you need to find out. If you don't know how to upload all of your files and have a server in space, you need to attend the conference. And if you don't know how to get anything that you want for as low as $5, you'll learn it at the conference. It's $39. Coupon code for members is WMTOUR, T-O-U-R, 11. Capital WMTOUR 11. And you can register for $39. And if you haven't heard, for $39, you get a awesome goodie bag donated by the Dr. Phillips Divas. You get $100 worth of gift certificates. And if you're a member, any member can put whatever they want into the goodie bag. So that's another member benefit. We will have 300 stellar, amazing women in this room. So it's an event that you won't want to miss. So for $39, $100 worth of goodies, a fabulous goodie bag, lunch, three great speakers, a wonderful trade show with 30 vendors at this event. So it's going to be an amazing event you won't want to miss. We are also in Central Florida planning a Derby Day for charity right now that's going to be a wonderful social in the month of May, a free social to all WOAMTEC members, and you'll hear more information about that coming soon as well. So, see, we'll be in touch with you in regards to that, but I just wanted to have you put it on your radar that in the month of May we're doing a charity for Foundation of Foster Children, Kids in Foster Care, and it's going to be a wonderful event. Now, I've also asked for us to meet with a new director in San Francisco, California. Daria is the first director to launch in Concord, California, is actually the city, and she is off to a stellar start. Daria is a business consultant, and she does coaching for entrepreneurs across the nation. So who better to reach out to get to know how we can join and grow our business and join together to create strategic partnerships? I'm going to turn the floor over to Daria in Concord, California. It's over to you. Okay, maybe it's not. We'll keep going. That's okay. You know, that's what technology is. Sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Just don't throw me under the bus. What I'm going to do right now while we're waiting on getting Daria to be back on our live broadcast, I'm going to turn the floor over to an amazing woman who is going to share the 8 tips to business success. And she is just a stellar human being that I just personally admire, and it's Barbara Cohenson, and she is an attorney. And Barbara, just tell us a little bit about who you are and what you do.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for inviting me today. It's such a pleasure to be here and to be a part of the WOAMTEC family. I am Barbara Cohenson. I'm an attorney, and I practice in the areas of estate planning, which is where we work with families and individuals to set up plans to help pass the property on to your loved ones to make sure your family is taken care of in the event something happens to you. Also, I practice in the areas of elder law, which allows me to help families that have elderly parents or members of their family that need to do some planning for long-term care. And finally, I also practice in the area of business law, which is what we're going to talk about today.
I'm ready to get down to the nitty and gritty. I think that's super exciting. So talk to me about some pointers that you could give our members from a business law perspective.
Well, I always remember things by acronyms. So I came up with one that had to do with one of my favorite things. When I get home at night, my feet hurt, one of the first things I like to do is kick my shoes off and put on my slippers. They are friendly, they're warm, they're comfortable, they make my feet feel so good. So we're going to use the acronym SLIPPERS to learn 8 things that we should all know about when we're in business. The first S is separate entities. Separate structure. We want to make sure that our business is totally separate from our personal lives. We have our personal life over here, we have our separate entity over here. That could be a corporation, it could be a limited liability company, it could be a partnership. There's many different types, and what type is best for you will depend on your individual circumstances. The reason we want to do this, though, is because we want to make sure that if something happens in our business that might go a little bit wrong, it's not going to impact our families or our personal wealth that we have. We want to keep them totally separate. The L in SLIPPERS is for limited liability. We want to make sure that we, once again, keep everything separate. We want to make sure that we have 2 separate accounts, that we don't pay our mortgage payment from our business account or pay some business expenses from our personal account. And we want to make sure that if we can, we want to make sure everything that is in our business is titled in our business name, not our personal name, And if we can get away with not without personally guaranteeing anything, a loan or a credit card, we'd like to do that. That's not always possible, but at least even if we have to do that, our liability will personal liability will be limited just to those things. The I in slipper is it must be in writing. It doesn't matter what it is. It could be an agreement with a vendor that you're going to use to get supplies from. It could be from a customer that you're going to supply a product for. It could be an agreement with a partner. It could be with an employee. The reason it needs to be in writing is because when you have an oral agreement and many months go by, first of all, people don't always remember what was said, and they don't always interpret it the same way.
Now, before you go on, I want to ask, when you say must be in writing, does it have to be something that was created by an attorney, or could it be an email? Could it be an email correspondence agreement? Talk to us about that.
Well, it could be an email correspondence. The only thing about what needs to be in writing is that it has to be very specific. It has to be something that you understand and I understand the same way. There's many agreements out there that are ambiguous. Mm-hmm. In other words, you can interpret something differently than I interpret it. So whether you go to an attorney, which is a very good idea if you're entering into an agreement with someone, but or if not, you just want to make sure that it's very, very specific in nature, and that when a third party reads it, they know exactly what it means the same way that the two parties that are participating in the agreement.
Okay,
no.
That makes sense. So what does P stand for?
All right, the first P stands for protecting your name, your logo, or your slogan. You have a slogan, you have a name, you're out there branding it, you've got all this goodwill behind it. You don't want somebody coming in and taking that name and using it for their own. There goes all your goodwill if that's what happens. So you want to protect it by looking at trademarking those things. And that's a process. It's not a difficult process. It's something that you should look into if you have a logo or a slogan or a name that you use on an ongoing business.
Now, is that if you just have, let's say you're a small entrepreneur and you're meeting in, you just have a chiropractic business in Orlando or in Atlanta or something like that, should you be concerned? Because I had a chiropractor just the other day say, well, it's okay if we're just using that in Orlando, but now I want to do something else that could get bigger and go nationwide. So is it just your small business entity, or if you're doing something in Orlando and somebody else discovers it in New York, could then that come back and haunt you?
Well, it could. It depends on where you've trademarked it.
Okay.
Because trademark goes along with usage. So if you have if you have a U.S. trademark, mm-hmm. you will tell them what areas of the country that you were geographically located in and doing business in. That doesn't mean that somebody in another geographical area that you're not in cannot trademark it as well.
Okay.
Okay, so it's just where you're going to use it, because use is part of trademark. You can't trademark something and then never use it.
Okay, that makes sense. Now, what's the other P? There's another P, right?
Oh, there's another P. Another P is to protect your confidential information or your trade secrets. You know, all of us may have little trade secrets that we use that we don't necessarily want out there for our competitors to know, or we may need to share some of our confidential information, our finances or something else with our employees or vendors. So we want to make sure that we have all these people that are going to have access to our confidential information sign a confidentiality agreement that it must be in writing, mm-hmm. So that our secrets don't get out when we don't want them to get out, okay?
And would that be like a non-disclosure agreement?
It could be a non-disclosure agreement. It could be a non-confidentiality agreement among employees. It can take all kinds of forms.
Now, what's the difference? Because I know I've used non-disclosure agreements through LegalZoom.
Right.
And not necessarily an attorney. And what would be the difference when would you caution someone not to do something casually and to reach out to somebody like you for your services?
Well, I would say that first and foremost, if you can go to an attorney, that's the best place to go. I don't know what LegalZoom's non-confidentiality agreement or non-disclosure agreement looks like, so I can't really speak to it. I know it was done by an attorney, but there are different state laws that may apply, and where that's a national website, I think it's always a good idea, even if you do it yourself, just to have an attorney, a local attorney, look over it to make sure that it's covered, because it's all about protecting you. It's protecting your business, it's protecting you, and it's protecting your loved ones.
And I think it's important too to mention that if something is blanketed, or if something is more generic, if something is more general, then it's truly not customized. So how could
Absolutely.
It be protecting you if it's not customized? So you need somebody that knows your laws, knows your state laws, and that knows your situation and circumstances to protect what we want and what you want as a member, as a person.
Right.
So I think now we're at E.
At E in slippers. E's all about employees. If you have employees, you need to understand the what it's like. What do you need to do? Do you need workers' comp? Do you need unemployment insurance? Do you know what the minimum wage is? What happens if you ask an employee to work overtime? Do you need to pay them? What happens if you have your own 401k? Do you need to offer it to employees? Very, very important. Also, if you have an independent contractor that you work with, and you have an independent contractor's agreement, that's fine, but you need to understand what employee means versus independent contractor in terms of the IRS, because you could be going along and using someone as an independent contractor, but it turns around that the IRS thinks that they're an employee, and all of a sudden now you have a bunch of payroll taxes to catch up on, probably with some penalties. So you have to understand the laws around having an employee and make sure that you treat them properly. You don't want somebody that maybe for some reason you need to let go to come back and have something to use against you. Mm-hmm. So we want to protect you from that standpoint.
I think that's really important. Absolutely. And I know that we've used your services many times, and especially as we're growing nationwide, I think it's important to connect with people that can help you to cover, dot all your I's and cross all your T's. I think it's very important.
That's right. That's right. R's are right for regulations. Regulations and licensing. There's some industries that have regulations. Like I know WOAMTEC has a lot of members that are in the food industry. There's a lot of regulations to be in the food industry. There's also professions like attorneys and doctors and CPAs that require licensing. So you need to know about regulations. You need to know about licensing. If you have a business inside a city or a county, you have to have a business license. So it's important to keep up with those things if you're in business. And then finally, we're to succession S, the last S in slippers, a succession plan. It's very, very important that you have a succession plan in place. This is especially if you're in business with a partner. If you're in business with a partner and your partner dies, what happens? Who are you in business with now? Her husband, her family, her kids? Maybe that's not what you want. So you need to have an agreement among partners as to what happens if one of you dies, if one of you becomes disabled, or even divorce, because maybe your partner would rather give her soon-to-be ex-husband your shares in the business in order to get the condo at the beach. Mm-hmm. So by having this all in writing, everybody knows what's going to go on if one of these events happens. And many times when I do estate plans for business owners, we have to make sure that they're congruent, that they work together. Or I'm working with a business owner that needs an estate plan. It's very important that that's all put together so that your family's protected, your loved ones will get whatever you have worked so hard to provide for them during their lifetime.
Absolutely. I think that's really important. And, you know, regardless of your business, I think that it's important to keep all of those points and those things in mind. So,
right.
Barbara, I do want you to tell them, if you could give them some of the, you are a remarkable woman because you made some changes in light later on in light and in life. And I told you before that I had toyed with the idea of going back to law school many times and just never did. And I sometimes look back and say, you know what, I wish I would have done that. So talk to me about that transition and the journey that you personally went through that many of these people may be able to relate to or may be feeling themselves.
Well, it's never too late to make a career change as long as you have that passion and you love it. I was in the corporate world for many, many years, very successful, did a lot to make a lot of money for a lot of businesses, a lot of corporations, and even though I might have been touching people, individuals, in an indirect way through the corporation, I never had that satisfaction that I was truly helping people or families. So I wanted to make a change in order to have that direct touch with people. I have a passion to help people. So I went back to law school later in life, which was a very, very different experience for me because I was among a lot of younger people who had different values than I was brought up with when I was in college. But it was absolutely wonderful, wonderful a journey for me, going back to law school 3 years and then entering the field of law and being able to practice the areas that I did do so that I can really touch the lives of people. I'm very, very fortunate to have the opportunity to really help a lot of people, and I'm so grateful for that opportunity.
So if you're a member and you feel stuck in a rut, or you just have this passion that's been placed on your heart and you're just not really sure, you know, why? You know, why am I going through this career change, or why am I having these financial struggles, or why do I just have this nag that maybe I should go back to school? Know that Barbara did it, and you're doing a great job in your life. I know you're happy. I can tell by the way you glow and by the way that you help others, which is super exciting. Now, I do think we have a couple of questions, so I'm going to turn it over to our webmaster. And C. Rivas, if you could tell us what our first question is.
Sure. Tanya Roller is asking, if I am based in Florida but plan on marketing on the internet and selling items in other states, do I need to get a national trademark?
I would say yes, absolutely, because you are now using your logo across all state lines. So it would really be a good idea to protect that logo or that name of your company by getting a U.S. trademark.
Okay, and I think we have another question.
The next question was, could you say what the R stood for again, please?
The R was for regulations. If you're in an industry that has a lot of government regulations, you need to be aware of those. You don't want to violate them, as well as licensing. If you need a business license or some kind of professional license, it's important that you keep those up to date.
Okay, one more question. Is that okay?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
The question is, what is the biggest mistake people make starting up a new business?
Well, there are many, but I would say probably many people start a business small in their house. They're doing something they love, and they never truly look at what it is that they need to do. Do they need a business structure? Do they need some protection? I'll give you an example. I had one client come to me one day with a jar of delicious salsa and a bag of chips. And he said, "Here, Barbie, I have to taste this."
Oh, now I'm hungry.
Oh, and it was absolutely fabulous. It was the best salsa I'd ever tasted. He said, "Well, guess what? I'm making this in my home, and I'm selling it." And, of course, I'm like, oh, my gosh, well, let's see, do you have insurance? Do you have a business? What happens if one of those ingredients that you put in there is tainted and somebody gets hurt? And, you know, I apologize. I don't mean to be all doom and gloom, but these are things that you need to look at, because if you cause someone harm because of your business, they will come after not only your business, but if they have the access to your personal assets, they will come after those as well, and then everything that you've built for your life, for your family, could be in danger. So it's important to really take whatever you're doing seriously and find out what it is you need to do to protect yourself and your family.
And, you know, I think that that's really important, too. And my answer to that exact same question was going to be the biggest mistake that a lot of people make is they don't have a business plan. They don't have a marketing strategy. And part of a business plan is actually sitting down and saying, okay, what do I need? What am I going to do? You know, how am I going to do this? How am I going to make money? Because if you're just throwing stuff up against the wall and hoping something sticks, or if you're just excited because people are throwing money at you, you increase your liability, but you also are running haphazardly. And whenever you run haphazardly, you jeopardize the safety of your family and of your business. And, you know, it's whenever it's too good, it probably is. So stop and talk to somebody like you did. So.
And, you know, today it's really important, too, because what I'm seeing in these challenging economic times is that people are being so creative and going out there and doing what they want. They're doing their passion. I remember Andrea Corte.
Mm-hmm. Angela Corte.
That was on this program saying that, you know, if you want to be successful, you do what you know, you do what you love, and you do what people will easily give you money to do, and it's probably so true. And I see so many people doing that today and being successful, but you know, they're having the fun part of being successful, but they really need to take a look at what the legal side of it is and how do they protect themselves.
Absolutely. It will cost you so much more in the end if you don't, you know,
right.
And that's the side too. If you end up owing more in taxes, or if you end up having fines, or if you end up, you know, violating things, or if somebody comes back and takes away your trademark, if you've just spent years and money and time investing in materials and marketing and all of that, you know, it's all deleted for nothing. So do it now. Protect yourself. Be proactive instead of reactive. We have one more question from our live audience, but what I do want to say is, even if you have much more questions, well, you've got some prizes to give away today, which is exciting.
I do.
The first one, tell us about the person in the state of Florida who has the newest business. So the person who has the newest occupational license, I guess, or the just launched their business first or most recently, is going to win what, Barb?
1 hour free consultation with me, either by phone or in my office, and that's a $350 value. So
that's awesome. So you need to tell C right now when you launched your business, so the date of when you launched your business, and you do have to be in the state of Florida because that's where she practices, but
right.
She did forget about all the other people that are out there. If you are out there and you have launched a business recently, but you are in maybe California, or you might be in Wisconsin, or you might be in any of our states across the nation, Maryland or anywhere, we want to hear from you too, because she brought us something extra special today. Barbara, what else are you giving away?
Well, I brought a $50 American Express gift card so that you can go out and buy a pair of really nice slippers so that you can remember the tips that we talked about today.
That is awesome. So I think somebody in like Maryland or Wisconsin or Chicago needs to win this prize so they can keep warm. Keep their feet warm. Warm up your feet and you put love in your heart. So if you are a member that has launched a chapter in a different state, or not launched a chapter, launched a business in a different state, and you let C know right now, you will win the prize of the $50 American Express gift certificate, compliments of attorney Barbara Cohenson. So, Barbara, thank you so much for being here today. C, do we have one more question?
No.
Okay, so I think we got all the questions answered. If you have any other questions, feel free to email it to C via the live chat feed, and we'll make sure Barbara gets your answers to you right away. And remember, the more you protect your business, you're protecting your assets. So reach out for help, and don't think you know it all, because when you surround yourself with smart, like-minded, professional, successful businesswomen, together you will all reach your goals much faster. So thank you, Barbara, for being here today. I appreciate you with all my heart. I appreciate
you.
It very much. Now I need to know, is Daria connected? Have we connected with Daria? I do believe she's there. So, Daria from Concord, California, we're going to hear from her right now, and I'm going to turn it over, my fingers are crossed, to Daria.